Thanks to Brilliant for supporting this episode of SciShow. Go to brilliant.org/scishow to learn more. My favorite second of the year is December 31st at 11:59 and 59 seconds, the moment right before a new year starts. So much anticipation, so much potential. But the speed of the Earth's rotation over the last year has some astronomers and computer scientists thinking that someday we might need an unprecedented adjustment, deleting a second. And if we do, the 11:59:59 second would be the one that gets the axe. Unacceptable. So there are generally two ways we keep time. One is just by looking up at the sky. If you call when the sun reaches its highest point in the sky, noon, and then you wait until the Earth rotates around and then it's noon again, that's exactly one solar day. Then there's Coordinated Universal Time, or UTC. That has nothing to do with what's going on in the sky. It relies on certain properties of atoms that change both very consistently and very fast. For example, the electrons around cesium atoms will jump between two configurations more than 9 billion times per second. Computer scientists figured out exactly how many of those oscillations fit into a solar second, and then defined the second based on that number. So in theory, the two methods should agree with each other. Except they don't, because the Earth's rotation is subject to all sorts of changing forces that mess with astronomical time. For example, the moon's gravitational pull can slow us down. But there are also more unexpected, unpredictable variables, like wind. You might have heard of the El Niño or La Niña systems, which are years-long trends in the winds in the Pacific Ocean. We usually hear them talked about in regards to how they affect weather, but they also tend to change the Earth's rotation for reasons that are not totally intuitive. Like a 2014 study in Geophysical Research Letters looked at this with El Niño specifically. One thing they studied was the Eastern Pacific El Niños, which are the ones that can lead to the biggest change in Earth's rotation, nearly a millisecond. And according to this study, that might have to do with the way they create pressure systems around the Earth's biggest mountain ranges. These El Niños make big high-pressure systems on the eastern sides of mountain ranges that ring the Pacific, like the Rockies, the Andes, and the Himalayas. Because the Earth rotates west to east, those high-pressure systems and the low pressure on the western sides essentially use the mountains as levers against the direction of rotation, and they slow us down. On the flip side, during La Niña times, the opposite can happen. Almost like the wind is pushing the Earth along its rotation by flicking its mountains. Another factor that affects the Earth's rotation speed is the amount of water in the oceans. Think of this like a figure skater doing a spin. The closer they pull their arms in, the faster they will turn. That is conservation of angular momentum at work. So when a lot of water is locked up in ice on land near the poles, like on Greenland or Antarctica, it's like the Earth's arms are tucked way in and it spins faster. But if that ice melts and it flows into the oceans, it's like the arms are flinging out the sides, and we slow down. Every day, all of these effects and more combine to give us a day of a certain length. But the computer scientists' atomic clocks don't care about how fast the Earth spins. They keep ticking along regardless. So to make sure we're all on the same page, whenever astronomical and coordinated universal time disagree by more than a second, everyone agrees to make an adjustment, a leap second. On average, over the past 50 years or so, we've only been slowing down, so we've only ever had to add leap seconds. But last year, we were pretty fast. We had 28 of the fastest ever days. All summer, Earth seemed to have a little extra pep in its step, and July 19th, 2020 clocked in at a whopping 1.46 milliseconds faster than normal. Now, it's hard to know for sure exactly why this is, but it's likely a combination of the processes we mentioned. Like, the wind patterns in the Pacific are in a La Niña phase, which should speed us up, and maybe the distribution of mass in the ocean was more figure skatery than in previous years. In general, as climate change causes more ice to melt at the poles and flow toward the equator, that should slow us down. But in some cases, when a current near the poles flows more slowly than normal and more mass gets concentrated at the ends of the planet, the Earth's rotation will speed up. That's actually something that happened in 2009, so maybe it was true of 2020 as well. Beyond this, there are also other factors that play a role, like interactions inside the Earth and the flow of the mantle. Regardless, scientists expect 2021 to continue this trend, and we might accumulate up to 19 milliseconds over the next year. Now, that's still 981 milliseconds away from a full second. So even if the Earth keeps up this pace, it may take a while before we need to delete a second from existence. But this change in trend is definitely unusual. So researchers will continue to keep track of how soon the sun comes up tomorrow, and why. And who knows, in a few years' time, they might be coming for 11:59 and 59 seconds on December 31st. And they can pry it from my cold, not dead hands. I'm not gonna hold on to it that hard. It's fine. Learning about the Earth's rotation involves a kind of surprising variety of scientific fields, but that's part of what makes it such a good puzzle. And if that's the sort of thing that you enjoy, you might want to try out Brilliant's Daily Challenges. They're questions about all kinds of science and are a great way to learn something new every day. And with every challenge, Brilliant also gives you all the context you need. If you want to try today's Daily Challenges for free, go to brilliant.org/scishow, and if you decide to sign up there, you'll also get 20% off an annual premium subscription.